Today is April 1st and I really want to prank someone.
Please tell when you want to eat. I don't want to decide.
So I'm gonna measure.
Hi.
What's up?
Did you ask for this?
No. But am I gonna do it?
Yes.
Why? Because I'm going gay.
Ben? Don't burn. It's okay. Don't burn. Okay. Hi, you guys. Welcome back to my channel. Hi, I'm Akanksha. So, I am leaving for Goa tomorrow. And I'm very, very excited because it is not just a normal vacation. It is one of my friend's bachelorette. So, lot of girls. I'm expecting a lot of fun. I don't want to jinx it, but you know, bachelorette, 12 to 14 girls is going to be a lot of fun. So I'm going to Goa tomorrow. My flight leaves at around 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock tomorrow. So I don't really have much time to do tomorrow morning stuff. Basically, I don't have much time to like wake up tomorrow morning. What is wrong with me? Wake up tomorrow morning and do stuff. Because like you know my flight is at 3:30, 4 o'clock, which means I'll have to start from my home around like 1:30, 2 o'clock, because 1 hour to the airport, then 1 hour private check-in, all that stuff. Anyways, my point being, I wanted to do like a prep for Goa, like show you what I pack, what I do, my preps before I go to the vacation. Or generally, I just wanted to do a vlog as like, you know what, this is the content I can give, because otherwise I'm just sitting at home alone, depressed, sad in my room, just editing and filming. So other than that, this is something exciting happening and like might as well show it. So I'm not sure like if I'm going to vlog in Goa. I don't think I will, firstly because it's bachelorette, it's once in a lifetime thing for the girl, but for the bride basically. And I'm not sure how many people are comfortable. I don't know a lot of people who will be coming, so I just don't want anybody to be uncomfortable. And I don't want to be constantly like with my camera and like, you know, I need to shoot this, something like that. So you know, to compensate for that, I'll do a Goa prep video, and here is one. So I wrote down a couple of things which I want to do, and I just realized I wrote it down in this phone, and I cannot read it out now because I'm filming in this phone and my brain did not actually think this before. First things first, I did check the list and I wrote down workout, which I actually did today morning, and I'm going to do one before leaving tomorrow as well. So I basically wrote that down because I'm not going to work out for the next 4 to 5 days while I'm in Goa, right? So I kind of wanted to get that out of the way. At least this week ka quota should get over, and the next week one which I come, like I can kind of, you know, balance it out or something like that. So next part is grooming and what else, like I've got to remove my hair, I'm gonna go to beach, I want my skin to be flawless and smooth and shiny and whatnot. It's so funny how in every vlog, like almost in every vlog, I have some part of hair removal, like just hairy girl problems, I guess. Like if you are hairy, you know this is like literally, this is your life. You've got to remove your hair literally every other day. And I mean, that's life. Like I kind of made my peace with it. But coming to hairy girl problems, I kind of talk about it also to kind of remove the whole stigma and taboo behind the hair removal or hair. There's a lot of secrecy behind it. It's just so damn normal, and you can have hair and you can choose to remove it or you can choose not to remove it. It's just that don't remove it because somebody is telling you to. It's if you are comfortable enough to have hair, it's really, really totally okay. But I chose to remove my hair, it's because it's just how I like it to be. So one of the reasons I like to remove my hair, especially facial hair, is because I love how my makeup lays on my skin after that. So nice, it's so flawless. So I, you know, previously used to use those like razor blades type of thing for my skin. Maybe they did remove hair a little bit, but they irritated my skin a lot more, and I stopped using them a while ago. I especially have acne prone sensitive skin, and I did not even realize how irritating that was. And I was just looking for something which kind of removed my hair but did not irritate my skin, and this Braun hair remover does just that. I know how it looks. Get your dirty minds in your pants. It's just a facial hair remover. I mean, I this is kind of the only action I'm gonna get anyways. My facial hair remover, it's a tool, it's you know, okay, anyways. So basically this is Braun mini facial hair remover, really nice and cute, right? So you just open it up, it comes with a cap, and then you rotate it and it switch on. You also already have a battery inside. If you want to, you can replace it, and once you use it, you can open it and, like, you know, kind of clean it off as well. So basically when you order it, you get it like this. I did just, like, you know, repackage it just to show you guys. You can open this up and then you have like an instructor manual, you have a brush which you can, you know, kind of clean the device with. So I'm going to just shift to the back camera and show you like my facial hair, because front camera really won't pick it up. So I don't really have like huge chunks of like everything, because I do groom myself every 3 to 4 days. It even has a spotlight in the side which makes hair more visible, which means you won't miss any spot. I love that it makes hair removal so easy and painless. Like, there's really no chance to cut yourself or hurt yourself, unlike threading or waxing, which is so painful. Just when I'm doing it, I just go like once or twice like this and it's like gone. So like I told you, it's operated with battery, and the size also is so small, so it's so travel friendly. You can put it like in your bag, in your purse, anywhere, and you can use it anywhere you want. So if you're interested in checking this product out, then I'll leave a link to this in the description box. You can check it out. I personally think it's a really good product to invest in, because it's a one-time investment. It works well anytime, anywhere, and a lot better than other methods. Braun does not just have this, it has various other hair tools like epilators, etc. So check the link to, you know, see more products. Now let's move on to the next step. So the next thing I wrote down is H&M. Hi you guys, what's up? We are in Navya's car and I'm driving, because Navya earned so much, worked so hard, bought a car, but she cannot drive. So we are going to H&M first, because I want to buy something. Navya is also going to go, but we're going separately, and she also wants to buy something. You want to buy swimwear or what? What do you want to buy?
Always had the dream, I'll see.
Yeah, so I wrote down an entire list of things I want to do today, but we're already pretty late, it's 1 o'clock, and we have to go back by 5 o'clock, so I don't know what to do. So first we were going to go to Forum. No, we're going to go H&M. To Inorbit, because H&M is in Inorbit. Tara, you wanted to go, no? Yeah, so we'll have to go to Forum. So we thought we'll go to H&M, which is in Jubilee Hills, and then go to Forum. So we did not eat anything, and we want to eat something, so we're first trying to eat. I have really high hopes for H&M. I don't want to get disappointed or something like that. Like, I want to buy headscarves, bro. I do not like any headscarf. I ordered one scarf, but it is not really great. No, first tell, where do you want to eat?
Okay, I don't know.
Please tell where you want to eat. I don't want to decide.
Right, I thought mummy gave me white. I don't want white.
H&M. This is my OOTD.
Well, nice and casual to shop. Yes, very cute.
I got all these. Let's try.
What did you do just now?
I didn't do anything.
What happened in H&M?
Nothing happened.
She wore a top and she forgot. The security alarms went key. We checked all the bags, that guy checked everything, and he's like, nothing is there. But then I realized she's wearing it inside her top. If you didn't buy anything, he would have thought we are thieves. I'm like, I don't know this girl. I went running to the washroom. Today's task is to buy shoes for my dad. Generally, like, he does not wear shoes. They have the normal chappal which they wear, so he wears that only for everything, even for functions he wears that. So the other day was going to a function, he wore, like, my dad wears white and white, like the typical politician.
That's
yeah.
So, that's an equal.
Yeah, and then he wants to wear shoes. So the other day when he was going to a function, he was wearing these running shoes, bro. Walking shoes and going. I was like, what are you wearing? You are not going out like that. He's like, no, all my friends are wearing, everybody's wearing shoes. I'm like, everybody doesn't have a daughter. Like, if you are my father, you should have some style. I'm not letting you go like that. Remove that, honey. I don't. He's like, I'll give you style. Please don't wear such things. So I'm like, I'll buy shoes for him so that he can wear, you know, normal. So brown leather ones or something like that. I'm thinking like that, faux leather. I make fun of people who wear, bro. I mean, my dad is not wearing at all. We used to have professors in our college who used to wear. They used to wear formal, full, okay? And they used to wear sports shoes and cuffs.
Somebody chitti na bulbul chitti chitti.
bought shoes for my dad and one shirt. So it done.
You know, I wanted to buy a lot of innerwear. I wanted to buy swimwear. I didn't really like. I don't think people, you know, even started summer collection yet, because majority was still like sweater vests and everything. H&M also had like more full clothes, not like, you know, cotton summer clothes, which are like more comfortable in the summer. And I didn't really, you know, like anything. So I did end up buying few things. So let's do a quick H&M haul. I'm in a mood today. Let's do an extent for H&M haul. So first thing I bought is this very nice cream color tank top. It's very basic, very simple. It's worth 799 rupees. Can be used on any different thing. Then the next three things. Really, the next three things, if you see what I got, you'll be like,
you suck. Yes, jackass.
No, but they'll be very useful. And rarely do I find things which I really like in this model, and which basically fit me perfectly. So that's the reason I got it. And literally, I bought five things, and three of them are very similar. Next thing I got is this bra top. This is a very nice lavender bra top. So basically, what always happens is, I'm gonna explain normally. So basically, what always happens is, like, I'm heavy chested and I'm not really comfortable with cleavage a lot. That's just like my choice. And I rarely find bra tops which I'm comfortable with. It's either like, you know, too much skin, or it does not fit, or whatever. And then I tried this one in H&M and I'm like, this fits so perfectly. So usually I'm in medium in normal like clothes or anything, medium to small, but this one I tried large, and large fit me very well. Like, there's a little bit of cleavage, but it's very super comfortable. And I don't have something like these things. You literally pair with like high jeans and just walk out of the house and they'll be so good. And finally I found something which fit me well and was very comfortable. So I bought three of this. So I got white, black, and, you know, lavender. Literally, this black and, you know, white, you can wear these even like blouses for any saris. And you want to see the last one I got is this really cute shirt. This is from the men's section. Like, if I go to H&M, it's like not possible to leave without going to the men's section, because they have such cute stuff, bro. Like, this boxy fit does not come in you know, female section. Like, let it be for sweatshirts or shirts, and I really like that. That's the reason I go to like the men's section always. So the minute I walked in, I saw this very nice floral, like, literally, I mean, you see the shirt and you're like, beach bitch. Like, I can pair such cool shorts and, you know, probably wear one of these bralettes inside and literally leave it just like, you know, full tomboy feeling. And that's literally the five things I bought from H&M. I went to Zara. I didn't really like anything. I didn't go to Forever 21. I really wanted to. And I had some other things to do that day, and I went shopping for my dad, and I didn't get things for my dad. But that was it. Okay, you guys, excuse the camera quality. I'm just using my mom's phone because today is April 1st and I really want to prank someone. And tomorrow I'm going Goa, and I'm going Goa with Raksha. So I want to tell her that I'm not coming, and I want to call her from my phone. That's the reason I'm using my mom's phone. And the reason I'll tell that I'm not coming is, so these tickets were kind of booked a long time ago, March 1st week only, and I was not going to go in between because I had like a shoot opportunity which I got, for which I had to go to Mumbai, and the dates were exactly during my Goa date, so I had to cancel for that. But then that shoot got cancelled. I don't know the reason why. So she knows that, you know, I got that chance and I was supposed to go, but it got cancelled. So I'm going to call her and say that I got the opportunity again and the shoot is on, and, you know, they're calling me and I really have to go. And of course, it's like a big you know, opportunity. She would like, I don't know what she would say. I just want to see her reaction. So I don't know why she's not answering. She's texting me and she's not answering.
Hello.
Hi, what are you doing?
Hi, what's up?
You came back home?
Yeah, I came back home.
Achha, listen, no, don't feel bad.
Okay.
That shoot thing again, they're saying it's on. So my manager is asking me if I can, like, you know, come back tomorrow to go to Mumbai, basically.
Oh my god, are you serious?
Yeah.
No, it's April 4th. No, I won't believe it.
No, really?
No, it's April 4th, I know.
Sure, you can little bit believe me, no, little bit.
Completely.
First you believe, no, little bit, then you realize that, you know, this is April. That's why I thought I'll actually do this prank in the morning. Then I was like,
you should have. Then yeah.
I was busy since morning. And I thought you'd be in office, so I was like, I'll do after you go home. Okay, bye. I'm going to get your dresses now.
Okay, bye. Okay. Bye.
Bye. Prank failed. Anyways, I'm going to go out now. I have to pick a few things and start packing.
Random shorts DIY.
So I'm gonna measure 48. So this is how the shorts look. I think they're fine. I can make it a little shorter, but I like the length. I want to keep it like this. Like later, if I do want to reduce the length, I can reduce it some other time. Okay, so I'm just trying to make this a little more like, you know, distressed from bottom. So I'm just trying to pull these bits out. Once you start pulling out, you'll get like this part. So you can keep on pulling how much ever you want. The more you pull, the more distressed it gets. So I'm about to start packing, and one tip I would give you guys is try your outfits on. Like if you're going for 5 days, then make sure you try every single outfit you're going to wear for 5 days, so that, you know, you'll stop assuming that you're going to wear something and put it in. Like once you make up your mind of what you're going to wear for the 5 days, you can pack those and only those, and maybe like one or two extra pieces, but not like, because I used to always do this. Like I'm going for 5 days, I used to like pack 10 more items, like, you know, probably I will need this previously. So trying your outfits on already, so trying your entire outfit on and what you're going to pair with what, so gives you a clear idea, and you'll understand that you don't need a lot of other things. So last 1 hour I just did that. Like I matched everything, I paired my outfits, and all these things are like ready to go in the suitcase directly. So first I'm going to put the, you know, outfit which I'm going to wear on the last day. Like I like to put outfits together so that it's easier for me to find. So basically I'm just going to try to arrange all my clothes on one side, maybe half this side, and rest everything will be other things which I'll be, you know, wearing. So next, this one. Okay, after clothes, this is how I pack my makeup and skincare. I like everything to be in pouches. I like to differentiate with my face care and my body care. So in my body care, I have my body moisturizer, then my body sunscreen. This is my menstrual cup because I'm about to get my period. I have my Braun facial hair remover in this as well. So in this one, I have all of my facial care. So I have my face wash in this, my sunscreen, my lip balm, my moisturizer, my night serum. I have like pimple patches in case I break out. I would need those. So this is all my facial, you know, skincare, and that is all my body skincare. So that way I can kind of remember which one has what, and it's easier for me to pick out and not mess up things. Next, for jewelry, I have a box like this. I put all my earrings, necklaces, everything in this. Now if it's layered necklaces, it's better to put in another separate box, but all the ones I'm carrying are single layer necklaces, so they won't get like tangled or anything. Put this in my handbag or check-in bag, and it's easier to find because all the jewelry together. Then the next one, which is the main one, is my makeup. Now listen, if you're a normal person who's not obsessed with makeup, like one little pouch, my facial care, this would be enough for all of your makeup. But you know, I just carry because people ask me stuff and I also need a lot of stuff. So this one comes really in handy because it's a lot more organized. So this one is from Amazon, and my friend just hand painted this for me for my birthday. This is AK. So this literally has everything I would need for like any basic makeup look. I put all my foundations, concealers here, my, you know, cream blushes, cream highlighters. I even have my neon pigments here because just in case I want to do like, you know, a fun little liner moment. I like to travel with minis because it's so much more convenient, because imagine taking the fat bottle of this one, it would just occupy too much space. So I have my, you know, lipsticks here, the Fay Beauty brush, and a highlighter and a bronzer. And then this even comes with you know, option for all the brushes. So I have my liners and mascara, my eyebrow pencil here, and all these are brushes. And then there's one more section here where you can fit an eyeshadow palette. So I have an eyeshadow palette there as well. And I just put this in the bag and it's always organized and I can find anything I want. So yeah guys, that's about it. That side has clothes and this side has all the miscellaneous things. I put my handbags in there, a blow dry brush, you know, the pouches. I just have to put my hat in there and my footwear, which is two pairs, which I just put in a cover and dump there. And yeah, that's it for my packing. It just is very, very organized and easier to find, and you know, things won't get messed up that easily.